What's up, y'all? It's your girl Formalot, and I'm back with another video. But before we get into this video, you guys already know what I'm gonna say. You already know what I need you to do. I need y'all to go ahead and hit that subscribe button and give this video a thumbs up. This video today is me bored as hell, and I was like, you know what, I'm just gonna make a video. I don't have any makeup on. I'm in my natural habitat, and I had some time, and I just realized y'all can see my wax stain. This is from candle wax. Yeah, so that's from wax, but we're gonna ignore that. So anyway, today's video is about what's in my dance bag. Maybe a year and a half ago, I did a what's in my dance bag video, but I did take it down because I just didn't like the way I looked. I didn't like the edit. Everything about it was just so amateur and I didn't really like it. So I decided I'm gonna update y'all with a 2021 edition what's in a dancer's bag. So again, if you haven't already, hit the subscribe button, give me a thumbs up, support me, please. But you know, I gotta drink my cranberry before we get into this video. Y'all, I love cranberry juice. Ocean Spray, y'all be doing it. Y'all be doing it.
Oh yeah. Cranberry juice made me just feel so good. It made me feel so good.
But okay. Again, y'all, please excuse my ratchetness. Like, I always make videos late at night because I'd be lazy during the day. It's like, it's 12:32 right now, so that's why I don't have makeup on, so my hair looks all crazy. But I really, really wanted to drop a new video, and it was either do this or wait till tomorrow to do some other stuff. But I was like, you know what? I need more stripper content. I need more stripper content. So I was like, I'm gonna go ahead and do this with some dancers back. So before I do get into this video, I am missing a couple things out of my dance bag because I haven't been to the store to re-up on certain items. So I will still say what is supposed to be in there if I am missing anything. I haven't really checked through my bag. Except when I washed my outfits. I don't really scope through everything inside. I just know what I'm supposed to have in it. So I don't know if anything's missing in my bag, but I am gonna show you guys everything that I do have in my bag, and I'm also gonna tell you what you need that I don't have in my bag if I'm missing anything. So before I do show you guys what's in my dance bag, this video is perfect if you are about to start dancing, if you're new to dancing, if you just want to look into dancing, or if you need tips. This video would be perfect because these are the things that you need every day. These are essential items every day while being a dancer. Like, I can't stress that to you guys enough. So every dancer everywhere is different, you know what I'm saying? So maybe not everybody has their stuff together like this, but this will give you the idea that you need to make it your first few days before you go in there and able to shop for other stuff that you pick up on when you go in there. So again, also y'all, get subscribed to my channel, give this video a thumbs up. I did just stutter, but we're gonna ignore that. And my Instagram, TikTok will all be in my description. If you haven't already checked out my TikTok, be sure to do that. I just hit 11K on TikTok, so I wanna say thank you to everybody who supports me on TikTok. I really, really do appreciate that 11K. We are growing, and I'm still getting followers every day. So I am completely, completely thankful for all the love and support, because I literally gained that 11K within a week. So I appreciate it. Like, y'all did the damn thing. Y'all snap. Y'all boys snap. Cause me, 11K? Can I get that on YouTube, please? Please. But anyway, we're gonna get into this video. Let's go ahead and get started. All right, so this is my dance bag. It's a gym bag. I did purchase this gym bag on Amazon. I think it was like $20. It wasn't that much. It's a Puma bag. It's cute though, right? One thing I do hate about this bag, it only has one side pocket. So, and I have like a lot of little small shit that I carry, so it kind of frustrates me, but that's we're gonna get into it, baby. We're gonna get into it. Okay. Hold on. Before we get into anything, I'm sorry, but I gotta hit my puff. I gotta hit my puff. It's just so good. Mm. It is just so
good. Okay.
We're opening the dance bag. Boom. So the first thing we're gonna do is shoes. So I have 3 pairs of shoes. I'm gonna show you all 3 pairs. No, I do not carry all 3 pairs of shoes with me because my OGs are my babies. But these aren't my OGs. They're my first pair of heels. These are like my 6 pair of heels, but they're getting worn the fuck out, so I gotta get new ones. But these are my OGs right here. And these are just some black boots. These are thigh-high black boots. And I love them. I love them. They are starting to smell though. I'm not gonna lie to you. They're starting to smell. The leather is coming off. I don't know if y'all can see that, but they're still decent though. Like, they're still decent. But they're worn. Okay, baby, they are worn. So I'm gonna show you guys the other shoes. I have to get them though. Hold on. Oh my god, my hair. I'm sorry, you guys. This is bad. Okay, we're not gonna judge. I like it better like that. Okay. We're not gonna judge these ones. These ones are old. I've had these for like 2 years. These are my first long pair of heels. So these are like my 3rd pair of heels. But these go to your, like, they cover your whole like knee down. Below, they are worn. They're dirty. I don't really wear these anymore unless like I'm trying to just switch up my look. For me, I don't really make money in these like I used to for some reason. So, but these, my babies, I'm making a bag and those guaranteed every time. These are iffy. I feel like they throw off my like vibe, you know. And then I got these, which were, okay, these shoes were out of my comfort zone. When I first started dancing, these would be the perfect shoes to first start dancing in, which are these. These are brand new. I've hardly even wore them, okay, because they're just not my style. I got them because I just wanted another pair of dance heels, but I didn't want to get the same thing over and over again. So, oh, by the way, all my heels are double stacked, which is double platform. If you are beginning, you might want to start off with a single platform first. I do feel more comfortable in double because it keeps your foot more comfortable. But yeah, these are really fucking cute. Like, but you can see the sweat in them, like from the lotion stuff. But these are really cute. I wear these once in a while as well. I don't really wear these as much because they're just not my style. Like, my whole leg to be covered because like my knees not to hit the stage, it hurts very bad. So yeah, these are a once in a while type of thing. And I usually only wear these with light colors because they're clear. But you can wear clear shoes with anything. That's just me. That's just me. Okay, so now we're gonna go into outfits. I'm gonna go from shoes to outfits, then I'm gonna get to the other stuff. Okay, so I don't really wear this outfit if you're insecure about, it just covers too much in my opinion. If you are insecure about your stomach, a one piece would be perfect. It's perfect, but I just feel like for me it's too covered. But this is one piece that I don't really wear. This is the back is open and it's like a thong back. So yeah, this outfit I've only worn like 5 times. It's in very good condition. It's brand new. I keep it in a Ziploc bag. That's another dancer tip: bag your outfits to keep them organized, okay? And it keeps them from getting tangled, or if they have gems on them, it keeps them from getting messed up, or you know what I'm saying, rubbed on anything, you know. Okay, so I have to go. I ain't gonna lie to you guys, I do need to go outfit shopping. I do plan on going outfit shopping sometime this week, so we're just gonna, you know, bear with me. This is a two-piece, but it doesn't cover too much. This is like one of my favorite outfits. I wear this very often. It's just a black, all black, and it like ties in the front. And it's like open in the stomach. So yeah, on my old YouTube video, I actually had a couple outfits like that. I think I actually showed that one too, because I've had that for a long time. All right, so now I'm gonna show you guys my OG, my money maker, my money making outfit. This is my baby. I love this outfit. It is almost done for though, I'm not gonna lie. So it's about the time to let it go. This one piece, and it's just strings in the back, and then this is the thong. This goes on your bed. So this is like the opening of it, or the back of it, the opening of the back of it, but it covers your full stomach. I like one pieces that do this with the back, with the thin strings, because it really like curves your body out. It makes you look really good. It's really a seductive look for me, you know. All right, so this is another outfit that I have that I don't wear. The reason why I don't wear this outfit is because it's a short outfit, but it has rips in it. It makes my ass look great. It makes my butt look great, but I just don't like how my butt moves in it, so I don't really wear it. But this is the top. It's cute though. I just realized like every outfit really that I showed has been Chanel. Guess I have a thing for Chanel outfits, I don't know. So yeah, that was that outfit. Nothing's wrong with those outfits. A lot of people wear those type of outfits. I used to like them when I was like insecure of my body because it covers a lot. I don't really like being covered too much now. I just don't like showing like my private parts. As long as my boobs and my coochie, you know, covered up, we're good. We are good. Okay, so this is an outfit I bought off a friend. I love this outfit too. This is really cute. This is the top and this goes like through the back. And then there's one wire right here, goes underneath your boob. So it sits like crosses. The only flaw about this outfit is that I don't have that big of boobs, okay? So these are the bottoms. The bottoms is like two-piece thong, you know. You know. Oh, wait. Okay. These are the bottoms. Super cute. I like the colors, like watermelon colors, Cosmo Wanda vibes. This is the lace thing that comes with it. I don't wear these. It's not really my style, so. I never wore that on my leg. I used to wear those when I first started dancing though, because I used to just think that was cute, but it's really not. Okay, so next outfit. I hardly wear this outfit again. When I do, I usually wear those silver boots. I'll wear those silver boots that I showed y'all, or the clear ones, because of how blue it is, but it's blue. So this goes around like this, okay? But it's open in the middle like that, black outfit, and it's just like that, but it has like more stuff. It's kind of hard to show you guys. I'm trying to show you the back. It's all tangled up though, but you get the idea, you get the idea. Another one of my favorite outfits is this one. It's like a, I never say it, bandeau. But it's this, it's see-through, so you wear pasties. When you wear outfits like this, you wanna get pasties. Amazon sells pasties in a pack, so I would tell you to go to Amazon to do that. But this is see-through, so yeah, and then you wear like a little thin thong underneath the bottoms because the bottoms are see-through. And this outfit is high-waisted, so it looks kind of weird, but it's high-waisted. And the only reason why I don't wear this outfit often is because this part is so long. Like, so long and loose. Like, I don't know why it was made that way, but I do like that outfit. I will push it. I will try to make it work as much as I can. Okay. Now I have a couple of these outfits and I'm gonna break it down why I have these kind of outfits, okay? Okay. Sorry, I'm untangling it. Okay, hold on. Okay, so this is like a string outfit. This is the top. I don't know what's going on right now, but the point is that it's just like that green and pink outfit. It sits on your boobs like this, little crosses. And these do fit me because my boobs literally are like this small. Okay, guys, literally. So, hold on, let me get y'all right a little bit more. There we go. Hold on now. Had to fix that light and get y'all right. So yeah, this with, where is it? With these. And these are literally just fishnets cut as shorts. You wear a black thong underneath this, but can you see the print? There it is. Okay. I get them in different prints and I cut them. Oh my God, I just cut my eye with something. Oof. Y'all, I'm so sorry, my eyes itching. I have a bunch of outfits. I'll wear like black regular tops, like this one, which looks like a swimsuit top, but it's actually not. It's actually a fabric. It's not like a swimming material. With a bunch of these, this is cute. I do like wearing shorts. It's cute. I haven't been wearing them in a while, but these go together, okay? And then this one, these are like, look, I'm gonna show you guys a perfect example. These are some old ones. These ones I didn't cut myself. I got these from a store that sells these. These ones are all like stretched out and ripped from dancing so much, people trying to tip me, ripping holes in them. There's gems on the back. And these actually have a hole in the middle from me like just ripping them from dancing. So you wear a thong underneath these. Some girls put holes in the back of them to make their butt stick out or in the middle on purpose. In this case, I didn't put the middle in on purpose. It just happened. So, but it's cute, so I'm not complaining. Okay, okay. Look, this is the crazy thing, you guys. These are the shorts that originally went with that outfit. That MCM one. These are the shorts. I cut the back out of these. So I don't usually wear these though, because the band like cuts my circulation off and shit, but I cut the back out of them. I don't usually wear them though. I don't think I have worn them at all. All right, so my last outfit is the long sleeve fishnet. So the long sleeve fishnet it's like this. It's literally like made into a top, a long sleeve top. Hold on, I'm trying to untangle it for you guys. I used to have a lot of dance outfits. I don't have any dance outfits anymore. I really gotta go dance wear shopping, because this is unlike me. I stay racked up on outfits, but I got rid of a lot of my outfits too, so I've been selling them. But this is the top. I actually don't even dance this because it'd be way too hot for all that. So I'm probably gonna like take some cute little pictures on Instagram in this. But this is the top. It matches those shorts I just showed y'all. You guys can see it. Don't wear those as no outfit out to the club, y'all, please. I've been seeing that a lot. That shit is not cute. Okay. Hey, that was it. Okay, yeah, so that's all the outfits. But now we're gonna get into the, I just found a Milky Way. And it's from like the last night I worked, so it's not old, so I'm gonna eat it. So the next thing that we're gonna do is we're gonna go through the essentials, the must-haves. And I'm gonna explain why you need all these things, because baby, some of y'all wasn't taught this. All right, so I have this little bag. I use this to carry like tampons, lip gloss. That's what's exactly in here is tampons, lip gloss, an emergency tampon and lip gloss. I definitely got this from somewhere because I don't even buy this kind. But yeah, so a lot of this stuff fell out. I keep lip gloss, tampon. If I keep a couple dollars in there for like if I need pasties that while I'm at the club, so I can go to the mama in the club and get pasties. Just little stuff, like just to stay organized, I use that for. Alright, boom. So I got my brush. Of course you're gonna want to bring a brush and your makeup if you like bringing your makeup to work. A mask, because you never know, okay? You never know, because people be having COVID, okay? You hear me? I don't ever wear a mask though. Oh, look, y'all, my crystals. If y'all want to know what these crystals like are for, let me know. Some headphones, just in case I get a phone call while I'm at the club in the dressing room, or if I'm just don't want nobody in my business, or I'm just trying to cut everybody out. The reason why I have regular wire headphones is because I don't have pasties. I mean, I don't have AirPods right now. I lost my AirPods. So, look, y'all. Oh, and okay, so remember this. I'm gonna show y'all. Tampon. Dollars. Emergency earrings. Gum. Another dollar and lip gloss. And it just fell out. So yeah, I also carry a comb. Those are really irrelevant stuff. So boom, here we go. Perfume. I use body spray because I noticed that when you spray body spray on you and you sweat, your sweat will smell like the perfume. I don't know if that's just me, but I don't know. It like really sticks for me, I guess. And I don't like using my expensive perfumes at the club. I really don't. I don't take stripping that serious. Like, I make sure I smell good 24/7, but I'm not finna go spray my good ass perfume on myself to sweat it off all the time. Deodorant. I have two because if anybody needs deodorant, y'all can use this one. This is my personal deodorant. I'm just nice like that. And because somebody always asking for something. Bye. Always asking for something. So boom, bitch, I got you. $2, you can use my deodorant. So deodorant spray. I don't recommend using Summer's Eve and shit. That shit not good for you. You're not putting this directly on your coochie. You're putting this around your coochie. Like, on the, like, you're just spraying, like, your lower area. Like, very lightly. And then you're going to spray your ass crack with this. It prevents sweat, and you don't want to, like, sweat and be stank. You know, your ass gonna start stinking. So, boom. This is the life changer. You can spray it under your boobs. It stops sweat anywhere. So, this is, like, must have, because you do not want to be musty in the club, because somebody gonna tell you, and if they don't tell you, they don't fuck with you for real, and they clowning you, okay? Because we clown anybody who stink. So if you stink, you clown. The next thing is that I don't have in my bag, but I is a bandana or a like scarf cloth type of thing that you can sit on, so you're not sitting on the bare seat. I haven't really been too worried about that lately. I used to really be like not wanting to sit on the chairs at the club or like the bench in the dressing room, but I didn't know, y'all, I kind of stopped caring about that, so I guess probably I don't carry one anymore. So yeah, if you're like germophobic, then that's like you need that, you want to sit on that. And of course you're gonna want to have your makeup or your makeup, you want to have extra outfits, you want to have shoes, you want to have hygiene stuff. But this is what my dance bag looks like. That's just what my dance bag looks like. I don't know how anybody else is doing it. I don't really have that many outfits right now. Due to the simple fact is I just been selling all my outfits. I think I said that already though. Pack it up because I go back to work in a couple of days. So I got to have everything together. So I don't lose anything. Ooh, them shoes do start to stink. I ain't gonna lie to y'all. Them shoes are starting to stink. So boom, that's everything that I have in my dance bag. A couple other tips that I do want to give you guys is if you're just starting, all you really need to start your first couple days to make your first little bit of money, just have 3 outfits and a pair of shoes. Yo, this is so good. You don't need all this stuff on your first day. You do need like most all the hygiene stuff. You do need that. But having like a whole bag of outfits on your first day is, you don't need that. You'll need about 3 outfits to get you through the first week, rack up a little bit, and then go buy you some shit that blends in with your club. Cause everybody at different clubs wears different things, and we all kind of like, everybody kind of like blends, I guess, if that makes sense. Something like that. So yeah, another thing that you do want to have is some pole grip if you do pole tricks, because the pole does get slippery. You will be slimy-ish, not like slimy, but you're gonna be sweating, so you're gonna be like moist all the time, like your skin's gonna be like sweaty. So get pole grip if you do pole tricks. I don't do pole tricks, so they just simply scare me. I do a couple, but I don't do too much where I need pole grip because they scare me, but you get the memo, baby. That was all for this video though, you guys. I just want to say thank you again for watching my video, and I hope this video helps somebody out there somewhere prepare themselves for their first day, or if they just needed advice or was looking for new ideas. I am gonna have a lot more dancer content available for you guys. I am working on it. I am going to also do a club vlog soon, but I am waiting on my friend's birthday to do that, because it'd be perfect to show you guys a birthday edition club vlog. So I am gonna drop that video after my friend's birthday. Again, if you haven't already, I need you to hit that subscribe button, give this video a thumbs up. Thank you guys again, and check out my channel for more videos.